Rollers session, a wonderful way just to reset your body after a long day of sitting. I was feeling particularly sore yesterday, and I just got out my roller and had a nice little wobble around, and it made me feel so much better. So I wanted to share with you guys. So you will just need your foam roller today. Labrador is not necessary for this workout, but it looks like this one is wanting to be part of the program. So, Emma, Daddy, come over on this side. Come on, good girl. So come and start on your foam rollers, lying down with your head and your sacrum supported. Let's just take a minute here just to allow everything in the back just to realign, readjust. Could you sit? Sit. All right, and oh gosh, you have to breathe in my face, it's not terribly pleasant. All right, just take a moment, close your eyes here, gently rock from side to side. Feel free to readjust. Oh, definitely feeling a bit tight in some areas myself today. How are you guys feeling? And just steady breaths in and out. Moment just to quiet your mind, quiet the body. Feel free to stay still or sway from side to side if that feels nice. Good, and let's just do some nice big circles with the arms. You can make them smaller, you can make them larger. Breathe as you move. Easing out the kinks right between those shoulder blades. So delicious. Beautiful. Take your circles the other way. For your shoulders. Flex your extended foot. Drop your ribcage down. Deep breath in. Big stretch. And then exhale, come back to your starting position. Go ahead and lift your left leg up. Hold on behind your thigh. Ooh, I've got some hip hopping going on. That's good. Releasing all those areas. We get tightness from sitting. Back give. Beautiful. Let go of that leg. Rest your left hand down. Reach your right arm up. Lengthen your left leg if you wish. And then slowly, slowly push your low back into the roller. Lower your limbs away from each other. Think like you're moving through mud or through water. It's very slow, very controlled. There's no rush. Drawing those limbs back up. And
and luring them away from each other again. Free to be like me and be as noisy as you want to with those breaths. Let it out, let that tension out, especially at the end of a long day. Let your heel touch the floor, big stretch. And coming back to your starting position. Beautiful. Feel free to readjust on the roller. Maybe take your feet out wider. Go ahead and reach your right arm to the side. Lift it off the floor, breathe in. Gaze towards your hands. And then exhale, take that arm across your chest. You will rock from side to side on the roller, that's okay. Breathe in, open out to the right side again. And this time, exhale, take your arm over your face. You feel that deep pressure release right in your upper back, between your shoulders. Breathe in, open to the right again. And exhale, sweep that arm across your chest, up and over your head, and releasing your arm down by your side. Beautiful. Let's do the other arm. So reach the left arm out, look that way, breathe in. Exhale, take that arm over your body. Breathe in, open wide to the side. Exhale, take that arm over your face. Breathe in, open to the left. Exhale, sweep that arm across, up and over. And release your arm down. Walk your feet in closer towards your glutes and be sure they're hips width apart now. Press your heels firmly down into the ground. I like to flex my toes off the floor for this one. Breathe in, reach your arms up overhead. You'll feel your chest expand, and then exhale, pull your arms towards your thighs. Tilt your pelvis so you feel your back lengthen. Option to lift your head and your shoulders off the roller, or you can keep them down, it's up to you. Breathe in, release your head down. Relax the tilt of your hips, open your chest, breathe in. Exhale, do that little curl, tilt your pelvis. Like a little abdominal crunch. Again, breathing, reaching up and over. Exhale, draw through. Let's do that one more time for luck, because it feels good, doesn't it? Breathe in, reaching up and over. And exhale, curl through. Nice, rest your head down. Readjust if you would like to. Just rest your arms in a comfortable position close to your side. Push your heels into the floor, tilt your pelvis under. Squeeze your bottom and maybe lift your glutes and your hips off the roller. Put your imaginary ball between your mid-thighs and pull those inner thighs towards each other. Push down right at the top, just above your shoulder blades, into that foam roller, and then roll down slowly, one vertebrae at a time. Once your back is down, let everything melt. Just let it go. Relax your feet, relax your hips, relax your face. Again, hi Jack. Tilt your pelvis, squeeze your glutes, lift your hips up, pull those inner thighs towards each other. Good, and then lower down slowly, one vertebrae at a time. Completely relaxing at the bottom. Oh, downward facing dog from Jack. All right, squeeze, tilt, one more time, my friends. Lifting up that mini bridge. You feel the top of the cervical spine is really getting a lovely stretch here. And then lowering down one vertebrae at a time. Melting at the bottom. Good, take your feet out wider. Gentle sway from side to side. Good, and then just gently coming off that roller, but keep it close to you. Keep your knees bent. You're going to place the roller underneath your knees. Emma, they cannot see with you there. Come over here, honey. I have distractions today. And lie down. Oh, God. Lie down. Place the roller.
very hard for me this series, guys, with this idiot in my face.
Oh, the joys of working out at home with your pets, right?
Alright, take your leg over your body next time it goes over. Sort of cross your thighs and just gently rock on that left hand side. So you're feeling a bit more of a release. Ooh, in the back of that left hip. Pretty sensitive around my hips these days, so excuse the moaning and groaning. It does feel ever so good just to release it. You're tuning into your body, you're telling your body to let go of any tension in a particular area by using the compression of either the foam rollers or the cripple balls. Beautiful. And then just unhook your legs. Lift that leg up and place your foot down. And then lift your other leg and we'll windshield wiper with the other leg, yeah? Just going across the body and out. My gaze naturally follows my toes.
You don't have to do that. You can look straight up at the ceiling. You can close your eyes. Breathing into the left.
wish you could see him, but Jack, my black Labrador, is in the other room right now, and he has his bone, and he is doing his trigger point Pilates on his bone. So he likes to put it on the floor and then roll on his back on it. He often does that when I'm doing trigger point Pilates. He's like, that looks great. I think I'll have a go. Wonderful. And then maybe lift your chin up and then bring your chin to your chest and still moving your head from left to right. So you're really releasing the back of the neck, the base of the skull. And we get so much tension from, you know, holding our shoulders up tight or clenching the jaw. Is that good, Jack? Just release that and then pop your roller down lengthways. Let's release the inner thigh and the hip. Excuse me, would you mind sitting? You're showing me up, Jack. They listen well, don't they? All right, and then just use your arms like kickstands.
Come over here. Sit.
And then rocking from side to side. That you're releasing those inner thigh muscles. Ooh. And you're in charge of how much pressure you put on here. Yes? So if you're a bit down, a bit lower, you're going to feel it more intensely. Or you can use your arms as a kickstand to lift you up a bit higher. Ooh, it feels lovely. Beautiful. One more breath. That and then do the other leg. Just going to turn around here. That roller just goes on your inner thigh there. Just roll it to the side, back. Ooh, don't be surprised if one side feels a bit more tender than the other. Mine does. Release the underside of the forearms, yeah? So your hips can come up high. It's like
child's pose into a puppy pose. And again, you're in charge of how much pressure you put here on the roller. Lovely, do one more. Try and not get your hair stuck underneath the roller like I'm doing. To one side, come and sit for a second. Now, if you can sit however you want to. You can sit on a chair if you'd like to. You could come onto your knees and maybe put a cushion underneath your hamstrings, between your hamstrings and your calf muscles. You can sit cross-legged. My hips are a little bit sensitive, so I'm going to sit in a modified cobbler's pose and just sit up nice and tall. Rest your hands somewhere on your legs. Breathe in, lower your chin to your chest, and as you exhale, take your right ear towards your right shoulder. Nice and gentle. Inhale, bring your chin to your chest. Exhale, left ear to left shoulder. So little semicircles. Yeah. Breathing in, chin to your chest. Exhale, right ear to right shoulder. Inhale, chin down. Shoulders forward, round your back, pull your belly button back, tuck your chin, breathe in, open up forward, so it's a seated cat-cow, yes, active stretch for your spine, exhale, round your shoulders forward, push all that air out, breathe in, sit up, open up, exhale, contract, very nice, bring it back to center. Reach your right arm up, or you can mirror me, whichever works for you at home. And then exhale, reach over to the side. Now, press your opposite glute down into the floor. Open your chest towards the ceiling. So if you have a beautiful waist stretch, lots of lengthening down the side of your body. Breathe in. Exhale. Lovely, and then coming on up, other side, breathe in, lift up first, exhale, reaching over, open your heart towards the ceiling, pull that top shoulder back and down, and your glutes too, breathe in, exhale, nice, coming on up, sit up tall, breathe in, rotate to the right, press your left hand against your thigh, keep nice and tall, stay here for a little bit, breathe in, lift up, exhale, maybe rotate further, breathe in again, lift up, exhale, twist, good, coming back to center, other way, lift up first, breathe in, exhale, rotate to the left, take your time, there's no rush, breathing in, lift, exhale, squeeze, so detoxifying for the muscles and the organs, breathe in, exhale, rotate, and then like a sponge as you unwind, all that blood flow is rushing through your body. So good for your cardiovascular system. And then just release around the top of the shoulders and the neck more. Let's create eagle pose with our arms. So bring your right forearm or your right upper arm underneath your left. And don't worry if you're like me and you can't hold on to your hands. Just do the best you can. Lift your elbows up, but pull your shoulders down and then draw your up to sitting. Release the arms. Roll the shoulders back. Good. Other arms. So arms to the side. Left arm goes underneath. Do the best you can with your hands. Lift your elbows up, shoulders down. And then reaching forwards. You're going to feel a nice deep stretch right across the top of your shoulders, your upper back.
Relaxes your body enough so that you can actually go to sleep with more ease at night and have a more restful sleep and not feel so sore and tight in the morning. So I hope you enjoyed it. Apologies for my beautiful distractions.